Hello dear students, today we are going to learn the topic protein engineering. Myself Professor Shilpa Rao from KFEWA College of Pharmacy, Nashik. This protein engineering is what? By using this recombinant DNA technology, we can modify the structure of protein. And accordingly, we can modify its function or we can improve its function. That is the basic thing behind the protein engineering. Different biotechnological principles are used for the modification of the protein. Say, for example, site-directed mutagenesis, then gene cloning. And by using this technique, we can modify the properties of protein. We can modify or improve the different functions of the protein. We'll see the definition, that is the modification of protein structure with recombinant DNA technology or chemical treatment to get a desired function for better use in medicine, industry and agriculture. It is one of the most exciting aspects of genetics engineering. Consist of design, develop and produce protein with improved operating characteristics. The techniques such as site-directed mutagenesis and gene cloning are utilized for these purposes. Means you can modify the protein structure either with the recombinant DNA technology or with the chemical treatment. Why we are modifying the structure? To produce the protein with improved operating characteristic. This is the motto behind the protein engineering. Then which techniques are used? That is site-directed mutagenesis and gene cloning. In genetic engineering, genes can be isolated and used for the synthesis of naturally occurring protein. Means naturally occurring protein we can produce by using this genetic engineering. Then objectives of protein engineering are to create a superior enzyme to catalyze the production of high value specific chemical, then to produce enzyme in large quantities, to produce biological compound including synthetic peptide, storage protein and synthetic drugs superior to natural one. Means the limitations within this natural protein we can modify by using the genetic engineering principle, or by using the chemical treatment we can modify or improve the activity. In molecular biology and genetics, mutation are changes in the genomic sequence. Mutations are caused by radiation, then viruses, transposons and mutagenic chemicals, as well as error that occurs during the meiosis or DNA replication. These are the reasons. Because of this reason, mutations are caused. Then site-directed mutagenesis, also called the site-specific mutagenesis or oligonucleotide-directed mutagenesis, is a molecular biology technique often used in a biomolecular engineering, in which a mutation is created at a specific defined site in a DNA molecule. Okay, means purposefully you have to create the mutation at particular site in the DNA molecule, that is known as the site directed mutagenesis. This technique for generating amino acid coding changes in the DNA gene. Then site directed mutagenesis is the incorporation of desired amino acid of one's choice in a place of specific amino acid in protein or polypeptide. Okay, site directed mutagenesis means purposefully you have to create the mutation within the nucleotide sequence or within the DNA structure. That is known as the site-directed mutagenesis. You can replace one amino acid with the another for specific purpose. Site directed mutagenesis is a technique for generating amino acid coding changes in the DNA by approach. Specific changes can be made in base of gene to produce desired enzyme. A large amount of experimental procedure have been developed for the directed mutagenesis of clone gene. A synthetic oligonucleotide complementary to area of gene of interest but has a desired nucleotide change. An oligonucleotide is a short piece of DNA, usually 10 to 30 nucleotide long. Directed mutagenesis can be done using M13 plasmid DNA, PCR, then random primer, degenerate primers, nucleotide analogs, and DNA shuffling. These are the different modes by using we can create the site-directed mutagenesis. Site-directed means at the specific site you can create the mutation within the gene sequence for the specific purpose. Basic mechanism: gene in a plasmid with target site mutation. Denaturate the plasmid and annul the oligonucleotide. The primer containing desired mutation using non-strand displacing action of PFU turbo polymerase extend and incorporate mutagenic primer resulting in neat circular strands. So this is the structure of your plasmid. You have to denaturate it and annul the oligonucleotide within the structure of this plasmid. Then you have to add the primer. Then digest the methylated non-mutated parental DNA template with DPN1. Then transform the circular neat double-stranded DNA into super competent cells. After transformation, super competent cell repair the neat at the mutated plasmid. Okay, means this is the mutagenic primer. You have to add this mutagenic primer. Then development of the template is there around this plasmid, and then mutated changes repaired. Method for site directed mutagenesis. First method is the single primer method. In this method, the primer is chemically synthesized oligonucleotide 7 to 20 nucleotide long. It is complementary to position of gene around the site to be mutated. Okay, means it is having a sequence complementary to the mutated site, but it contains mismatch of one or the base to be mutated. Okay, means within this primer one base is mismatched. The starting material is single stranded DNA carried in a M3 phase vector. Okay, this darker structure is the target single stranded DNA within this M13 DNA vector. Then you have to add oligonucleotide primer with one mismatched nucleotide. Then mixing this DNA primer with the oligonucleotide hybridizes with the complementary sequence except at one point of the mismatched nucleotide. Okay, means hybridization of this mismatched pair and target DNA is there, but only one base pair is mismatched. Then hybridization possible by mixing at low temperature with excess of primer and the presence of high salt concentration. Then you have the wild type DNA and mutant type DNA.
with you.
The addition of 4 deoxyribose nucleotide triphosphate and DNA polymerase, usually new fragment of E. coli DNA polymerases replication occur. The oligonucleotide primer is extended to form complementary strand of DNA. The end of the newly synthesized DNA is sealed by enzyme DNA ligase. Means after completion of the synthesis, joining of the structure is there, and with the help of the enzyme DNA ligase. Then double-stranded DNA containing mismatch introduced into the nucleotide into E. coli transformation, and the infected E. coli cell produces M3 virus particle containing either original wild type sequence or mutant sequence. Means these M3 phase you have to introduce into the host cell, that is the E. coli cell, for the further multiplication. And during this multiplication you have two types of the sequences. First is the wild type sequence and second is the mutant sequence. It is expected that half of the phase M3 particle should carry wild type sequence while half mutant sequence is of your half mutant sequence and half wild sequence. The double stranded DNA of M13 are isolated oligonucleotide directed mutagenesis by using plasmid DNA is also in use. Then some variations in the use of oligonucleotide directed mutagenesis. Instead of one base mismatch, 3 base mismatch is there. Then insertion of sequence is there, means addition of some sequence in the primer. Then deletion of sequence is there in the mutant oligonucleotide. These are the 3 different techniques. Then cassette mutagenesis. In cassette mutagenesis, a synthetic double-stranded oligonucleotide containing desired mutant sequence is used. Okay, in previous method we have used single-stranded DNA sequence with the M13. But in cassette mutagenesis we are using the double-stranded plasmid DNA. Cassette mutagenesis possible if fragment of the gene to be mutated lies between the 2 restriction enzyme cleavage. The intervening sequence can be cut and replaced by synthetic oligonucleotide. Means you can change the sequence in between 2 cleavage site only by using this cassette mutagenesis. The plasmid DNA is cut with restriction enzyme, for example EcoR1 or HIN111. Then you have to add the mutant sequence and join it with the help of ligase and then transform into the host, that is the E. coli. Then PCR amplified oligonucleotide directed mutagenesis. This is the diagrammatic representation. This is the tube 1 and this is your tube 2. What you are doing in the tube 1 and 2? The PCR based mutagenesis technique commonly employed is depicted in a first. The target DNA is cloned to plasmid vector and distributed into 2 reaction tubes. Okay, these 2 tubes are the 2 reaction tubes. To each tube is added 2 primers. One primer A in a tube 1 and C in a tube 2 is complementary to the region in a strand of the clone gene except one nucleotide mismatch. Means you have to add a sequence of primer or A primer in the tube 1 and B C primer in the tube 2, but it is having a structure complementary with the complementary to your you can say mutant sequence, but only one base pair is mismatched. Now in other primer B in a tube 1 and D in a tube 2, okay, then you have to add D primer in tube 1 and D primer in tube 2. Means now your tube 1 consists of A and D primer and your tube 2 consists of C and D primer. Is fully complementary sequence in other strand with the adjacent to the clone gene. If you see the diagram, now A strand is there, again B strand is there, here C and D. The placement of primer for hybridization in each tube is done in opposite direction. The PCR technique is carried out for amplification of DNA molecule. The product of PCR in the two reaction tubes are mixed. Okay, means you have the two product in the two reaction tube, then you have to mix that product. Then DNA molecule undergo denaturation and renaturation, and A strand from one reaction tube hybridizes its complementary strand from other reaction tube, that is C strand. Okay, means what happened? You have to add A primer, you have to add B primer, then you have a double stranded DNA with you, and here you have to add C and D. Okay, now you have the two tubes with you along with this four primer, then you have to mix it, both the tubes you have to mix, then denaturation is there, renaturation is there, and there is a mixing of the genetic material. A is having a complementary sequence to C, that's why A is attached with the C and B is attached with the D. Again you have to transform this mutated sequence into the into the E. coli, and then there is a further multiplication. Okay, in this way, by using the polymeric chain reaction, we can create the mutagenesis. An application used to generate mutation that may produce rationally designed proteins that has improved or special properties. They also used for the investigational tools, specific mutation in gene allow the function and properties of DNA sequence or protein to be investigated in a rational approach. And then commercial application, protein may be engineered to produce protein that are tailored for specific application. Then example commonly used, laundry detergent may contain substrates in whose wild type form has methionine that can be oxidized by bleach and inactivating the protein in the process. This methionine may be replaced by alanine, thereby making the protein active in presence of bleach. Okay, means such a type of the modification helpful for the bleaching purpose. The inside directed mutagenesis has been widely used in study of protein function. Now we'll see different approaches of the protein design and protein engineering. First, increasing the stability and biological activity of the protein. Okay, means by using this different technique, we can improve the stability of protein and activity of the protein. Then slight changes are required in the structure of protein, and these changes are made by using the protein engineering. Now we will see which type of the changes are required for the improvement of the stability and biological activity. First change, addition of disulfide bond. What happen when you add this disulfide bond? Increases the thermostability of the enzyme. Example, T4 lysozyme and xylenase. Then changing the aspargine to other amino acid. If your amino acid of the protein structure is having your aspargine in it, then you have to replace that aspargine with the other amino acid. Then what happens? Thermostable enzyme with improved biological activity is formed. See, for example, try isophosphatase isomerase. In this structure, aspargine replaced by threonine or isoleucine, then you will have the thermostable triisophosphate isomerase. Then reduced free sulfhydryl group, improved stability and activity. If you remove the sulfhydryl group, it increases the activity and stability. For example, human interferon. Then single amino acid changes also improve the stability and increase the activity. In case of alpha 1 trypsin, oxidative resistance is developed when replacement of the single amino acid is there. Then in case of insulin, improve the stability and activity. Then in case of tissue plasminogen activator, it is useful for the dissolving the blood clots. Its half-life is very less. Slight changes in the amino acid sequence modify the half-life of the tissue plasminogen activator. Then pyridine increases its potency by using the genetic engineering. Now second technique is improved kinetic properties of enzyme. How can you improve the kinetic properties? By using the site-directed mutagenesis. For example, substilene, aspargine. Then protein engineering through chemical modification. Certain types of the cross linkers are used for the modification of the protein. This, for example, glutaraldehyde. It is used for the stabilization of the protein in the solution. For example, insulin, then hemoglobin, then lactate, dehydrogenase. Then protein engineering through chemical modification. Okay, this point is repeated. Then protein engineering by use of gene family, isolation of gene from known family, DNA shuffling create by hybrid of the different combination. Means within the same family, you have to take the two protein molecule, you have to hybridize it and form the newer protein or protein with the improved properties. Okay, this is all about the protein engineering. Thank you.